This is the Highway View Farm. I'm Martha Crete. We milk cattle here. We have about a 220 head milking herd. Total herd size just under 500. We do raise about 500 acres of corn for corn silage, 250 acres of grass for the grass crops. Our milk goes to Dairy Farmers of America. Ultimately, it ends up with HP Hood in Boston. And the corn silage we use for our own cattle, and then we also sell to a lot of area farmers for their feed. Yeah, we have diversified a little bit to prevent loss in that we have quite a sweet corn business growing. We plant about 15 acres of sweet corn a year and sell most of it right out of our driveway at a little corn wagon right at the end of the driveway, and sell most of it there. In the past, we have wholesaled to some of the places in Concord, but this year we just did it right out of the driveway and did well. And then we're also touching a little bit on beef sales, so trying to sell a little bit of dairy beef, and we'll see where that takes us to help diversify, keep the money coming in. To help us out on different questions, we may go to Extension. Depending on the question, we'll talk to our nutritionist, other area farmers. We've actually talked to people out in New York who will help us with a question here on crops. We try to find somebody within that industry to help us with questions. We're right in the middle of town, so that poses a risk factor as far as acceptance with the public. We try to maintain a public image within the community, and also the pricing. Milk pricing is a big challenge for us right now. We do use crop insurance, and we have used it for many, many years. Basically, we insure at a catastrophic level. Because we have two farm numbers with all of our crops, if we have a small area that's damaged, it's usually averaged out, and overall we don't get much of a loss. But it is at a catastrophic level on just corn silage. The farm numbers are assigned by the Farm Service Agency, and it goes by the ownership history. So right now one of our identities owns one number. The other identity owns the other number, and the property is assigned to those numbers by the ownership. Crop insurance is a gamble. You certainly hope that you don't have to make a claim, but I don't quite dare not to have it because I'm afraid of those years would be the years that we would need it. So for that, I would do my best to try to at least have catastrophic coverage. I don't have any direct experience with the NAP program. I have considered it. You pay $250 per crop that you sign up to $750. I've considered it for our hay crop. At this point, we haven't done it. You need at least a 50% loss, and then if you have a 60% loss, they pay you only a percentage of that 10% that's over. So at this point, we have not done it. Thought about it a lot, but haven't committed to it. And you have to sign up prior to that year. So I think the sign-up has just completed for the 2011 year. After this year, we did think seriously about it because a lot of our hay crop was hit by drought. And it's a $250 fee. We just paid out a lot more than that for hay. So it would have been a good thing to have this last year, absolutely. They call it, I believe, SURE, and it's a revenue-based. There again, it's a catastrophic coverage that you would have to prove that you had at least a 50% loss in your crop. In order to qualify for that, you have to have had crop insurance on that crop. So we would be able to, possibly for the corn silage, but we didn't qualify, and I didn't have NAP insurance on the hay crop, so I can't qualify. Wow, Well, hopefully we're going to continue. We're here for the long run. Adam has taken over the farm. He manages the farm, the day-to-day operations. Together we make the financial decisions, but I certainly hope with the milk price stabilizing, hopefully we'll be able to stick it out and we'll be here for a long time. Possibly to get a little bit larger, possibly to change some structures, get some new barns, new milking parlor. It's all down the road. It's what we'd like to do, so we'll see. I think you have to really run it as a business, bottom line. You've got to keep track of your expenses. You've got to not be afraid to take some steps, perhaps in insuring, or we've done a little bit of the forward price contracts. Touch on that a little bit. I don't know, just try to hang in there and ride it out.
I'm Adam Crete. We're milking just over 200 cows. Our cows are milked three times a day through a parlor that we milk 18 at a time. Our cows are fed a diet consisting of corn silage, haylage, wet brew, dry hay, and a grain. And our dry cows and our heifers have different diets than our milking cows do. If we ever run into any problems on the farm and have questions, we've got a few people we'll contact. We'll talk to our vet, or we'll call our nutritionist or a UNH extension agent or another local dairy farmer. Some of the biggest risks are definitely the weather. This past year we were affected largely with the drought. Our hay crop was very small. We've had to buy hay for the first time in a long time. Our corn yields were down quite a bit. So the weather is a big factor. Hopefully the future holds a lot of good things. Hopefully we'll be around for a while. It'd be nice to see some new barns and a new parlor, but you know, in order to do that, we're going to need some good milk prices and just some good years to come. I think some of the keys are, like I said, trying to cut your costs, you know, trying to do things inexpensive, but making sure it's still done quality, and being efficient. I keep doing this every day because it's what I enjoy doing. You know, it's more than just a job, it's a lifestyle.